Hello, my dear students. Today we are going to discuss our next grammar chapter, Models. Now let's start discussing about models. Models are the helping verbs which are used with the principal verbs to express certain moods as ability, obligation, permission, request, suggestion, advice, and so on. For example, they will go out. Will is used to show future tense. They may go out. May is used for the possibility. They can go out. Can is used for the permission. They should go out. Should is used for advice. Now, my dear students, let's discuss how do we use models. So, the formula of using models is subject plus model auxiliary verb plus main verb plus object. As you can see here in the example, Mary could play piano. We are using Mary as a subject. Afterwards, we are using the model auxiliary verb could, and then we are using verb play. One more thing I want to tell you, my dear students, that model auxiliary do not need any of the auxiliary verb with it. One more thing I want to tell you, my dear students, that with model auxiliary verb, we always use basic form, or you can say the first form of our main verb. As you can see here in the example, in all the examples, we are using first form of our main verb. Now, as I told you that we use first form of the verb with model auxiliary. One more thing I want to tell you, my dear students, that we cannot use s while using our verb with singulars, or we cannot use do or don't, does or doesn't in the question or the negative form of the sentence. As you can see here in the example, he can ski, but we can't use he can skis. Would you like to do your work? We cannot use here do you would like to do your work. The next point I want to explain to you all is that with model auxiliary, we cannot use ing form of the base verb, or we cannot use infinitives with it. We use infinitive, but without to, or you can say bare infinitive. As you can see here in the example, she must study. We can't use here she must study. ing form can't use. We also can't use she must to study, because we can't use infinitive with to. We have to use bare infinitive without to. So the correct sentence is she must study. Here we are having the list of model verbs, and the model verbs are can, could, may, might, will, would, shall, should, ought to, and must. Models have different uses. Now we are going to discuss its different uses in the sentence. Now let's start with our model verb can. My dear students, can is used to show the ability to do something in the present. For example, Alia can speak English. Here, can is used to show the ability in the present tense. Alia can speak English. That means presently Alia is having the ability to speak in English. Our next model verb is could. Could is used to express ability in a weaker manner. As for the example, I could read even without eyeglasses. So in this sentence, the weaker ability of mine is here explained, that I could read without sunglasses. My dear student, could is also used to show the past tense of the ability of the person. Now, come to the model verb may. May is used to indicate permission, wish, or possibility. Now come to the example. It may rain today. Here may is used to show the possibility to rain today. We are showing with the help of may the possibility of rain today. As I told you that may is also used for asking permission. As the example is given, ma'am, may I go out? Here what we find that the person is asking permission to go out. Now, come to the modal verb might. Might is used to show possibility, but the less possibility. As I told you previously that may is used to show the possibility. So, what about the might? Might is also used for showing possibility, but in a less possible way. For example, it might rain today. Here what we find, the possibility is showing, but in a less possible way. Now let's move towards the modal verb must. My dear students, must is used to show force or necessity and express advice or the recommendation. As the example is given here, I must go to the supermarket today. Here what we find, I must go. That means it is necessary to go to the supermarket today. So here must is explaining the necessity of doing something. As I told you that must is also used for expressing advice. As you can see here in the example, you must see the doctor for you to be sure about your condition. You can find out that someone is giving advice here to see the doctor. So it is clear that must is used to show the necessity of doing something as well as for giving advice. Now our next modal verb is will. As I told you, my dear student, previously in the verb chapter, that will is used as the future helping verb. So, my dear student, will is used to make a prediction and it is also used to show the request. Now, come to the example. I will be rich. Here what we find that the prediction is given that one day I will be rich. As I told you that will is also used to show respect. You can see here in the example, will you get my purse on my table please? So what we find that somebody is requesting to get purse on the table. Now it's time to discuss next modal verb would. Would is the past tense of will and it is also used to make a request. As you can see here in the example, would you mind if I join you? So what we find that somebody is making a request, but in the past tense. Now come to the modal verb shall. My dear students, shall is used for advice or suggestion. As the example is given, shall we dance? So what we find that I am giving suggestion to you to dance. Now our next modal verb is should. Should is used to express condition, probability or the duty or the necessity. As here in the example, a student should attend classes regularly. I think now it's clear to you that here should is used to express the duty of the student, that it is the duty of the student to attend classes regularly. Now come to the next modal verb ought to. My dear students, ought to is used to advise or make recommendation. It also used to express assumption, expectation or the strong possibility. In other words, you can say that ought to is used to express the moral duty of someone. Now come to the example. She ought to stop eating red meat. So here the recommendation is expressed that she should not eat red meat. In the same way, As I told you that it is used to express moral duty. So for the example, we ought to love our country. So it is our moral duty to love our country. So here ought to is used to express the moral duty. Now at last have a quick revision of models. So models are the helping verbs which express the mood or manner of the action. Action means verb of the subject. Model verbs are used to express the ability, possibility, permission, obligation, and so on. Can is used for ability and request. Could is used for ability in the past tense, suggestion, and the future possibility. Now it's time to may and might. May is used to express permission or the future possibility. And my dear students, might is used for the same, but in a weaker way. It shows the less possibility of something. Now come to shall and should. Shall is used for offer or the suggestion, and should is used for the advice, or you can say the uncertain prediction. Now come to will and would. Will is used to show the willingness or the prediction that is certain. Come to the would. Would is used for request. Must. Must is used to show the necessity or the obligation. And as I told you, ought to. Ought to is used to show the duty or the moral obligation. That is called the moral duty of someone. Now, in this way, it's the end of all, and thank you and have a nice day.